The new Audi e-tron GT electric four-door coupe has been launched in India, with prices starting at 1 crore 80 lakh rupees for the GT Quattro variant and going up to 2 crore 5 lakh rupees for the top-spec RS variant. The electric sports car gets the signature e-tron pattern panel instead of the grille, bold sculpted lines and a large indentation on the bonnet. The matrix LED headlights are standard on the RS variant. The cabin sports the familiar virtual cockpit and touchscreen display, along with low-positioned sports seats at the front. Power on the e-tron GT comes from two electric motors, one on each axle, that is paired with a two-speed transmission and an electric all-wheel drive. The standard e-tron GT Quattro produces 523 brake horsepower and 630 Nm of peak torque, while the RS e-tron GT gets an output of 637 brake horsepower and 830 Nm of peak torque. The e-tron GT Quattro has a range of 500 km on a single charge, which drops to 481 km on the RS version. The RS e-tron GT can sprint from 0 to 100 km per hour in 3.3 seconds, with an electronically limited top speed of 250 km per hour.
It's a very important day for us, and after the success that we've seen with the e-trons that we just launched exactly 2 months back, and we are so happy that we could bring this car and we could convince our headquarters to give us these cars, because we believe future is electric and it is becoming electric faster than we all thought of and thinking for the future. So I think all of us are very, very happy that we are able to get both these cars and able to bring the fastest or the strongest cars that Audi has ever built to India.
Tata Motors is dropping new teasers of the upcoming Punch Micro SUV, and the latest image reveals the interior of the new offering. The Tata Punch will be the company's smallest SUV yet, and the new image reveals a minimalistic dashboard with a dual-tone paint scheme. It will get horizontal aircon vents with blue bezels and a Harman-sourced touchscreen infotainment system similar to the one on the Altroz and the Nexon. The infotainment system is likely to offer Android Auto and Apple CarPlay connectivity, and possibly the Aira connected car technology as well. The image also hints at the AMT gearbox option on the Punch along with the manual, which will be paired with a 1.2-litre petrol engine. Tata Motors is expected to reveal the Punch in a few weeks from now, with the launch scheduled around the festive season. Honda has finally pulled the wraps of the new generation BRV SUV in Indonesia. The all-new offering is based on the N7X concept showcased earlier this year. Unlike its predecessor that was based on the Brio platform, the new version is based on the same platform as the Honda City and shares several components, engine options and features with the compact sedan. The second generation Honda BRV continues to be a three-row offering. The SUV looks larger than its predecessor and also sports better cabin space with more safety tech. The new BRV will draw power from the familiar 1.5-litre iVTEC petrol engine in Indonesia, tuned for 119 brake horsepower and 145 Nm of peak torque. It will be paired with a 5-speed manual and a CVT automatic. Honda has not announced if they plan to bring the new generation BRV to the Indian market.
We simply love, love, love hearing from you. So your comments and feedback are important. Subscribe to our channel, react to this video, and of course, watch our other videos too.